Good afternoon, YouTube. Welcome back to The Truth According to Lily. I'm your host, Lily, and today we are doing a Halloween theme on my nails, and we're going to be watching an episode of Star Trek, the animated series. I haven't chosen an episode yet. There's really not a lot to choose from, quite frankly, but let's just go through this. So I believe the last one that I watched from the animated series was the Lorelei Signal. Wait a minute. Episode 2, Yesteryear. Spock traveled back in time to prevent his death as a young boy. Okay, we're gonna watch this one. So we're gonna be watching Season 1, Episode 2 of the Star Trek the Animated Series, Yesteryear. Okay, can we skip this, please? Skip to the end.
Skip to the end.
A Birdman? Wait, are they just dropping us already into the middle of an adventure? I'm loving this. An Andorian first officer. I'm feeling it. I'm digging it. I keep saying there needs to be more Andorian representation. You can't just keep killing them. What happened indeed, Jim? They're like, who's this bitch? Well, something got fucked up, bro. Well, let's face it, Kirk, you could never forget Spock. While we were in Orion's past, the time revision that took place here didn't affect me.
They checked the Starfleet records him at the same and asked for. Your findings? There is no Vulcan named Spock serving with the Starfleet in any capacity. Larry the Vulcan, ambassador to 17 Federation planets in the past 30 years.
That is not correct. It is a mistake. I wish to ask a question. What of Sarek's family? Wife and son.
Amanda, wife of Sarek, born on Earth as Amanda Grayson. The couple separated after the death of their son.
Cyborg?
The wife was killed in a shuttle accident at Lilliput on her way home to Earth. Ambassador Sarek has not remarried.
My mother. What was his name and age when he died?
Spock. Age 7.
I knew it wasn't going to be Cyborg. Okay, I know. That was added way later. Okay, so like, is this bird dude like a member of the crew? Because he's using like a tricorder thing, but he doesn't really have a uniform. I mean, I don't really know how he would really have a uniform. I mean, he's covered in feathers. But I'm just saying, like, is he a member of the crew, or is he just hanging out with the Guardian, and is he some sort of like liaison? I haven't like heard them call him by a rank or anything yet. I'm just curious. Imagine that, like, I hear everything and it's really loud. Get some earplugs. I'm really liking this Andorian character. I wonder though. Oh my God, what if this is the character, the Andorian character that's gonna be in Strange New Worlds? I mean, I doubt it, because a lot of people are pointing out that the Andorian character in that looks very pale, kind of like those subterranean, blind, telepathic Andorians were. I don't think they're called Andorians, I think they're called something else. No, it's not the same character. That would have been pretty cool though. That would have been pretty freaking cool. I just had to check. I just had to check. Oh wow, this is like directly from Star Trek 2009. Interesting, J.J. Abrams. Interesting continuity.
My apologies, Visitor. I regret you are witness to that unfortunate display of emotion on the part of my side in the battle. All is silence. No more will be said. Live long and prosper. Sorry for both. Peace and long life. You are of my family. My name is
Please. Sarek is a lot of things. Absent father, kind of a douche sometimes, but he ain't stupid. Is he really an absent father though, or is he just a Vulcan father? You know what I mean? Just saying. Also, I love rediscovering little episodes and things like this within the Star Trek franchise, because it's stuff that, I don't know, kind of builds upon like the Star Trek world building and everything. And I don't know, I just really like that. I really do. Right, boo? It's kind of this giant like man-eating teddy bear thing. That's hilarious. That Amanda Grayson, I believe, described Spock's mom in Journey to Babel. I like how this is obviously not the actress who played Amanda Grayson's voice, or played Amanda Grayson in Journey to Babel. This is clearly Majel Barrett filling in for almost every female vocal part besides Uhura. But she's even drawn like Majel Barrett. She doesn't look anything like the Amanda Grayson live action. Sorry, if you hear a lot of noise, they're doing shit outside. I think Brian's cutting down a tree. I like how he's like, oh shit. We won't talk about it right now. Just don't die. Somebody's sneaking around. I think it's just the kid. Again, I really like this building upon more Vulcan philosophy, Vulcan culture. I've always found it very, very interesting. I would totally be an Amanda Grayson and marry a Vulcan. Like, that would totally be something I would do. Or if I was just human, I would totally have a Klingon husband, without a doubt. I love Klingons. Don't tell a little baby to stay. He wants to come protect you. Oh, there he goes. Oh my God, what's going on? That's mean. All right, Spock, should you really be making like personal logs when you should be going to save your younger self so that you don't cease to exist? Like, that seems to be like top priority, not making these personal logs. And he's just gonna power right through it. Little shadows just running around. He's gonna try and save him, but he didn't, so that must mean, oh no. Chaya, no. Oh my God, Spock is Spock just neck pinched this like monster thing. We're the same person, but don't think too much about it. Oh no! Oh no! Not a Chaya. Again with the personal log. Apparently, the whole planet is a desert, Spock. See, Spock, that's why you need your sensitive side. Because you do kind things like that. Where another Vulcan might have just been like, eh, there's nothing we can do. Vulcan is a really dangerous planet. Like, everything there seems to want to kill you. I like this guy's house. Super weird looking. Whirring. Woo! Spaceship. No, probably not a spaceship. It's probably just good for like land cruising. Okay, so he's just gonna go around neck pinching all of his bullies? Do it! But I must carry on. You saved my son's life, Senator. There is no way I can fully repay you for that. Try to understand your son. Sorry for both. It will be repayment enough for me. Strange. Yes, but he won't. Understand his son, and he will actually never get a chance to say, I love you. And all of that good stuff. So tragic. No, you won't. We all know you won't.
I sent the others up to the ship. One small thing was changed this time. A pet died.
A pet died? Oh, hi. I'm doing a Star Trek watch along. The episode's almost over. There's like 2 more minutes left. It's not a movie, it's Star Trek the Animated Series.
Well, yeah.
Ryan, he doesn't want to be in here.
He just doesn't know what he wants. I have my animal and you have yours.
He looks pissed.
That's his normal face.
That's a cartoon?
Yeah, Star Trek the Animated Series. It came out after TOS was canceled.
Don't know what that is.
Star Trek, the original series?
Yes.
And this came out afterwards, but it only lasted 2 seasons.
Obviously.
Do you want to watch the rest of it? I can crop you out if you want.
I want the cat in, but me out.
Well, iMovie doesn't do that. I can't blur your
face. Just put a cat filter.
I don't have a cat filter. It's iMovie.
Put his butt in there.
You're going to have to let him out. He wants to go. He wants to be in his room. Street gets the spare room. That's his bedroom.
Look, he's fine. He's just looking.
Okay.
I cut down some of that tree.
I heard. Yeah, I could hear it. I'm gonna finish watching this episode.
Well, so you two
Oh, fun. Don't tell him what he knows. Times change in an episode about time travel. Well, viewers, that was a very interesting episode. I'm really sad Ichaya died. I thought that was kind of unnecessary, but it's kind of like, you know, life for a life, I guess. I'm not really sure. Pets die, which is really sad. Spock needed to learn about death, I guess. But yeah, that was season 1, episode 2 of Star Trek the Animated Series, Yesteryear. So yeah, thank you for watching this episode of Lily Watches Star Trek and you watch me watch Star Trek, and then hopefully you watch the episode. Thank you for watching. Live long and prosper, peace and long life, and stay tuned and turned on for more. Bye!